Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Assalamu alaikum, students. This is the online session of Safa Intellectual School. I'm your English teacher and I'm going to give you lesson number one today about parts of speech. This is a review lesson. You already know about adjectives and adverbs. I'm just giving you a review lesson in a different aspect, in a different perspective of these two parts of speech. Adjectives and adverbs. They are the two most commonly used words in a sentence. We often confuse them with each other and this creates a problem. Today, I hope that this lesson will clear up your mind about adjectives and adverbs. This is a listening activity. First, I will play something for you. You have to listen it carefully and then see what of impact that listening gives to you. The objective are to review the concepts of adjectives and adverbs. We have already studied many times adjectives and adverbs in different lessons, different classes, but today I'm giving a different concept of adjective and adverb. I want you to recognize them. I want you to recognize immediately when you see them in a sentence. To learn the use of adjectives and adverbs in the writing, how you're going to use these words in the writing, that is important. And then to describe a picture. When you are going to describe a picture with adjective and adverb, you must know how to describe it. And building strong listening skills. These are the objectives of today's lesson. Before listening, you will do some pre-listening discussion. I'm about to give you a song, okay? You are going to hear that song and then you have to find out what is in it. But before starting the song, I will ask you a question. What do you understand with the title, What a Wonderful World? This is the title of the song, What a Wonderful World. From this topic, I understand that it is about world. Wonderful world means beautiful world, the beauties of the world, the things that are good in this world. This song is about that. What do you think? Do you think I'm right? Do you think that these words are giving this impression to your mind? Then do you ask questions before listening? What are adjectives? I know the answer, but please think about it and tell me, what are the adjectives? Yes, adjectives are the words that describe the noun. If we have a noun, we don't know about it. We use words like adjectives to know about it. I have a chair, but you don't know how does it look like. So I will explain you that it is of wood. It is of brown color. It has four legs. And it is round in shape. So now you know that I have a table with round shape, four legs, and wooden. So adjectives explain you this way. The question is, what are adverbs then? With the word add and verbs, you can already understand that add verbs, those words which are adding something to the verb, it modifies the verb. The action, what is happening and in what way it is happening. The adverb explain it to you. So adverbs are the words that modify the verbs. You're about to listen a song. The lyrics are written. Try to look and find other words the singer is using. I'm giving you all the lyrics on that songs. Okay, look. What a Wonderful World. The lyrics are written here. We'll just sing it for you and see how it's pronouncing in each and every word. So, have you heard the song? Did you enjoy it? This is a song about the wonderful world. How I see the trees of green and red roses too. I see them bloom for me and you, and I think to myself, what a wonderful world. I see skies of blue and clouds of white, the bright blessed day, the dark sacred night. I think to myself, what a wonderful world. The colors of the rainbow, so pretty in the sky, are also on the faces of people going by. I see friends shaking hands, saying, how do you do? They're really saying, I love you. I hear babies cry, I watch them grow. They learn much more than I'll ever know. And I think to myself, what a wonderful world. Yes, I think to myself, what a wonderful world. What a wonderful world it is. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had made this world so beautiful, pretty. Everything in this world is so beautiful that is created by Allah. Trees, birds, colors of rainbow, and all type of things. Sky, clouds, and then darkness of the night. Everything is very beautiful. And this is how he recognizes it. Now, after listening it, we have to discuss something. First, tell me, what did you like, didn't like about the song? I liked about the song. I am giving my suggestion to you and then you have to think about it and answer the question. I like the beautiful things he's discussing in that song. I also like all those things which are in this world, like rainbow. And especially when he says that the color of the rainbow is also seen on people's face. Like when they are happy, all the colors they can see. You can see not only happy, you can see the color of blue when they're sad. You can see the color of yellow when they are really sick. And you can see the color of red when they are angry. And you can see the color of green. And the color of red also shows when they're happy and when they're sad. So all these colors of rainbows can also be seen on people's face. So this is the lovely part of the song. And there's nothing to to say that I don't like about it. I loved, absolutely loved that song. What do you think? You should give the suggestion as well. What is the theme of the song? What do you think is the theme of the song? It is very clear with the topic that the theme of the song is to discuss about the beauty of the world and how wonderful the world is. The theme is to actually describe all the beauties in the world. Forget about the sadness. Forget about the bad things in the world. Forget about, for 1 second, please, forget about every bad thing in this world and think about good things. Think about beauty of the world that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has created. What is the mood of the song? Sad or happy? I don't think it's happy. I think it's a little bit sad, or maybe not sad. It's a kind of a mood which is describing like you, when you are appraising things, when you are fascinated by things, you're not quite sad, you're happy, but not like happy, not like excited, not like shouting, wow, I'm happy, no, but in a very emotional way you're happy with. So the song is emotional, you can say, and the song is very touchy because it is about beauty of the world. Now, after listening this song, your practice one is to find adjectives from the song. Yes, don't forget that we are studying adjectives and adverbs. So this song is I have chosen this song for you because it is particularly full of adjectives, beautiful adjectives, attractive adjectives. This is wonderful to learn adjectives. So we have to find adjectives from the song, and then we have to find nouns from which these adjectives are associated, for which these adjectives are used. I will tell you how. From the poem, I find out green, greener, trees of green, red, wonderful, blue, white, bright, blessed, dark, scared, and color, pretty. These are the adjectives that I have found out from that poem. And then I will explain to you how these adjectives are associated to the nouns that are used in that. Green is used for trees. Red is used for roses. Wonderful is used for world. Blue is used for skies. White is used for clouds. Bright, blessed for day. Dark, scared for night. And color, pretty for rainbow. So you can see every adjective is associated with a noun. It means adjective modifies the noun. Adjective describes the noun. So now you know that with every adjective, there must be a noun. Okay. Today, we'll also discuss something about adjective phrases. Adjective phrases are those phrases in which we use adjectives. Phrases, you know, there's a difference between a sentence and a phrase. Sentence is a meaningful, complete whole part, and in which we can understand the meaning of it. It is a complete thing. But phrase is not complete, it is incomplete. But we have to see that how we make adjective phrases. Okay? Now see, I see trees of green. This is trees of green is adjective phrase. Red roses. Now we are making trees just like trees of green. Trees of green is already an adjective phrase. So we are making red roses. We are making the adjective phrase of red roses. Roses of red color. Okay. Then blooming red roses. This can be another one. Blooming red roses. Because he's saying red roses too. I see them bloom for me and you. So you can make red roses and bloom all are associated together. So we can say blooming red roses. Then world with wonders, wonderful world. Wonderful world. The phrase will become world with wonders. Day with brightness. Here it is. Bright, blessed day. Day with brightness. Day with blessing, because it is blessed day. So day with blessings. The night that gives scare. Night that gives scare. So now we know that from adjective noun, we can make a phrase, adjective phrase as well. Like bright blessed day can become day with blessing, day with brightness. Night with scared nights, you can have night that gives you a scare. Okay, so all these are related to each other. So see, here not only we can identify adjectives, but we can also make adjective phrases. I hope that you have understood all about adjectives, that adjectives describe the noun. Adjectives are always found before noun, okay? And we can make phrase, adjective phrase, by adding an adjective to a phrase. It becomes an adjective phrase, okay? Now we are going to do another listening activity that is related to a school report.
Hi, I'm going to read Ivan McGregor's report. In English, he's taking A. Ivan is a very good student. He writes very clearly and his imagination is wonderful. German, B. Ivan doesn't speak German very well. However, he tries hard in the lesson. Math, B+. I'm pleased with Ivan's grades this year. The lessons are often difficult, but he thinks carefully. History, C. This year was terrible. He doesn't do homework properly and often makes mistakes.
Now here is Ivan McGregor's school report, okay, in which there are grades, there are subjects, and for every subject, there are comment sections. So see, in this report, you can see there are some underlined words, okay? We will discuss that afterwards, but what do you guess what are they? Clearly, well, hard, carefully, properly, often. What do you think they are? Yes, they are adverbs. They are used for verb. How they're used for verb, I will tell you later. But before that, he has to see that these adverbs are used exactly after the action word. He writes clearly. Writes clearly. He doesn't speak German. Speak well. Then he tries hard. Tries hard. So they are associated with the verbs. He thinks carefully. And then he doesn't do properly and often makes. So all these are the adverbs connected to the verbs. So what do you think about Ivan McGregor? That he is a good student, but he is not good in history. And he is not very good in German, but still he's trying. But in history, he's terrible. So that's how we can guess about Ivan McGregor. Have you seen the underlined words? I've already told you the underlined words are all adverbs. What are the words they are associated with? That I have already explained to you that they are associated with the verbs. All the adverbs are associated with the verbs. Now see, in practice two, we have to find adverbs from the report and then find associated verbs. So clearly, well, hard, carefully, properly, often. Now they are clearly associated with writes, writes carefully, well with speaks, speaks well, hard with works, works hard, carefully with thinks, thinks carefully, properly with do, do properly, and often is with make, makes, often makes. Okay, so now you can see that all the adverbs are associated with the verbs, and they describe the verb, they modify the verb. How he writes clearly. How he speaks well. How he works hard. How he thinks carefully. How he does his work, he does it properly. How he makes often, how often. So he is actually telling the time of verb. We are not discussing here the types of adjectives or adverbs, that is a long discussion. I want you to just give a review of what adjectives and adverbs are, and then we will be able to do it. Now there are two exercises, adjective exercise and adverb exercise. The first we are going to do is adjective exercise. Read the passage and fill in the blanks with given adjectives. The words adjectives are given here: wonderful, beautiful, freshly, colorful, cool, hot, and pleasant. Now here you have to write it here. Today the weather is very dash. What should be the weather like? It should be wonderful, beautiful, freshly, colorful, cool, hot, or pleasant. Today the weather is very hot. I am sitting in my lawn. It is dash here. Obviously, I'm sitting in the lawn, so it must be cool here. Dash breeze is blowing. Now, you can write cool here or you can write pleasant here. It is pleasant here. Okay, not very hot, not very cool, pleasant. And then you write cool breezes blowing. I want to concentrate on my work, but smell of dash, freshly baked cakes, is making it hard for me to concentrate. There are dash flowers, colorful flowers, in the lawn, dash butterflies, beautiful butterflies and bees are hovering around. It's really dash scene, wonderful scene. So look how many adjectives we have used in this exercise. Now we are going to do adverb exercise. Look at the language table and complete the exercise below. Now see, fluently, slowly, dangerously, hard, quietly and neatly. Bill drives very dash. He'll have an accident one day. Now the next sentence is explaining about Bill's driving. He'll have an accident. And he's such a bad driver that he will have an accident one day. So he is dangerous. So dangerously. Bill drives very dangerously. Steve doesn't write dash. I can't read his handwriting. Now the next sentence is explaining about Steve's handwriting. That's not very good because nobody can read it. So Steve doesn't write neatly. That is the answer. Cyril speaks to dash on the phone. I can't hear him. Now, when you can't hear somebody on the phone, it means she is speaking slowly. So Cyril speaks too slowly on the phone. I can't hear him. Snails move a very dash. We already know they move very slowly. Okay. Jack works really dash. He often stays in the office all night. Now the next sentence is telling that Jack is very efficient. He stays in the office all night to work. So that means Jack works really hard. Jenny speaks Spanish dash because she lived in Avila for 3 years. Now Jenny speaks Spanish because she was living somewhere in Spanish speaking country or city. That's why she must be speaking fluently. So Jenny speaks Spanish fluently because she lived in Avila for 3 years. Now here the word, one word is left, that is quietly. You can use for Cyril speaks too quietly on the phone. It slowly will be okay, but you can use quietly as well. Cyril speaks too quietly. Quietly means very, like, it's almost silent when she speaks. You can't hear anything. All right, so this is the adverb exercise. Now the key features of both adjectives and adverbs, I want to explain it to you because sometimes students confuse adjectives with adverbs. Look, adjective describes the noun, so their associated word will always be a noun or a pronoun because they actually describe the noun. Adverbs modifies a verb, and thus its associated word will always be a verb. So always remember that if a word is explaining the verb, it is adverb. If a word is explaining a noun, it is an adjective. This is a simple enough thing. You should remember that. Now, use of adverb and adjective. I am actually explaining it because of your confusion sometimes. Okay, sometimes same words are used for adjective or adverb, but they are used differently, which you cannot recognize. Now see, adjectives. Ali is a fast driver. She is a beautiful singer. Sadia is a slow learner. Tom is very intelligent. He is getting late. Replies. Now, Ali is a fast driver. Driver. Can you see? Driver is a noun. So the associated word is noun. So the fast is an adjective here. She is a beautiful singer. Singer is a noun. So beautiful is describing the noun. Sadia is a slow learner. Learner is a noun. So slow is describing the learner, means the noun. Tom is very intelligent. Who is intelligent? Tom is intelligent. So Tom is a noun and intelligent is the adjective. He is getting late replies. What replies? Late replies. Replies is the noun. So late is describing replies. Adverbs. Ali drives the car very fast. Now the fast is the same word as used in adjective, but look how differently it is used. Ali is a fast driver, means driver, associated with driver. Ali drives very fast. Drives is a verb. So Ali drives very fast. So here fast is used for drives, it means it is an adverb. She sings beautifully. Here, beautiful. Here, beautifully. Sings beautifully. Verb is sing and beautifully is adverb. Sadia writes slowly. Slowly. Slow. Slowly. Adverb with writes. Used with writes. Tom answers intelligently. Intelligent. Intelligently. Answers intelligently. Answers is a verb. He is getting late replies. He replies late. Late associated with verb, with action. Here, late is associated with noun, replies. To see, there is the difference between the use of same adjectives and same words for adjective and adverb, but you can recognize them with the use of it. They must be used accordingly. Now see, there's a picture I've given you. The picture is of a park. Children are playing there. Now we have to describe this picture first with adjectives, then with verbs. I will give you sentences with adjectives first. It is a beautiful garden with lots of green trees. The children are happy. They are playing different games. Beautiful buildings, tall buildings can be seen outside the boundary wall. The weather is pleasant and sun is shining brightly. So all these are adjectives. So now I'm using adverbs. The girl is taking the swing very fast. The boy is kicking the ball very hard. The girl is doing some difficult gymnastic. The seesaw is moving quickly. The boys are playing with the ball perfectly. So now these are the adverbs. You can also write your own sentences for this picture. Write 5 adjective sentences and 5 adverb sentences. and see how you do it. Your homework is, do adverb exercise and adjective exercise in your notebook, the one that I've given you. Write minimum 7 sentences about a member of your family or a friend using adjectives. You have to use the adjective. You can write about your mother, your father, your friend. Just 7 sentences with 1 adjective each. So 7 total adjectives you have to use for a person or anyone you like. And write a paragraph using adverbs. This paragraph will be written with the picture. With the help of the picture I have given you, use that picture and write some adverbs. Thank you so much, class. I hope you've understood this lesson. Inshallah, we'll meet next time with a new topic. Till then, Allah Hafiz, take care and do your work. Do these exercises and do this work in your notebook.